Hello everyone, welcome to Jagran Public School, Noida. In this session, we will study the physics chapter, force and the laws of motion. This is our part 4. Till part 3, we studied Newton's second law of motion. So in this part of force and laws of motion, we will discuss some questions regarding to the Newton's second law of motion. Means how we can apply Newton's second law of motion in reasoning questions. So as we studied earlier in Newton's second law, that Newton's second law basically the calculation of unbalanced force which is described in the first law. In the first law of Newton's, it was described that if an object was at rest, it will remain at rest, and if the object is in motion, will continue in motion unless and until an external unbalanced force acts on it. So in Newton's first law, it has been discussed that some force is required to change the state of rest or state of motion of an object. In Newton's second law, we will discuss about the force, and this topic has been discussed in part 3, that force is directly proportional to change in momentum upon time. Means force is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum. Rate of change of momentum means momentum or motion of an object is changing with respect to time. If we increase the time, the effect of force on an object reduces, and if we decrease the time, the impact of force on an object increase. So this from equation 1, that is F is directly proportional to mv minus mu upon t, represent that force is directly proportional to change in momentum and inversely proportional to time. So this law, that is this equation, we will apply in our reasoning questions. So according to Newton's second law of motion, force is inversely proportional to time. So the Newton which discussed about the force, and now in the second law, there is a calculation of the force. So from this equation, the conclusion is that force is inversely proportional to time. How we will apply this force is inversely proportional to time? Let's start. So this is the application of Newton's second law of motion. So according to the application means we are going to apply force is inversely proportional to time in every question. So you have to be careful by reading the question, ki which law you are going to use it. Either it would be inertia or it would be a Newton's second law. So the first question is, why a fielder pulls his hand backward while catching a ball? You have all seen in a cricket that fielder when catching the ball pull his hand backward. So the reason behind that, a fielder pull his hand backward while catching a ball coming with a great speed. Actually, while catching a cricket ball, the momentum of the ball is reduced to zero. Means catching a ball means a fielder reducing the motion of the ball to zero, means ball is getting stopped. When he catches the ball is stopped. When the object is stopped, means momentum becomes zero. So if the ball is stopped suddenly, means the momentum is zero, its momentum will reduce to zero instantaneously. Instantaneously means within a second. If a fielder will catch a ball, its momentum will reduce to zero within a second, causing the instant rate of change of momentum due to which ball will exert great force on the hands of player. So if a very less amount of time the player reduces the momentum to zero, it will exert a great force on the hands of the player, due to which the player hands may get injured. Therefore, by pulling the hand backward, a fielder gives more time to change the momentum to become zero. So if the player pulls his hand backward, means to stop the ball from motion to come to make it at rest, means momentum is changing from motion to zero, it will take more time to reduce the momentum to zero. So if the time will increase, this prevents the hand of the fielder from getting hurt. So the less force will be applied on the player's hand. So when these type of questions are there, we will apply that force is inversely proportional to time. If we increase the time of what? Of change in momentum, then the force applied on the hands of the player get reduced. Got it? Now in the same phenomenon, next question is, why there are seat belts in a car are provided? Seat belts in a car are provided to prevent the passenger from getting thrown in the direction of motion. Means in case of sudden braking or any accident, passenger may get thrown in the direction of motion of the vehicle and may get fatal injuries. Whereas the stretchable seat belt prevent the passenger's body to fall suddenly and thus increase the time of the rate of momentum to become zero. Means when the passenger is sitting in a car, suddenly when the car stops, the passenger body thrown in the opposite direction. So the seat belt increase the time of change of momentum. If we increase the time of the rate of change of momentum, this will reduce the less force on the passenger body. So this prevents the passenger from getting any fatal injury, and a big injury can be reduced. So this is also the question of the same phenomenon, that force is inversely proportional to time. The time of change in momentum or the rate of momentum to become zero is increasing, and the force applied on the passenger body will become decrease. Similar way, come to the next question. Why in a long jump cushion bed is provided at the place of landing? For athletes of long and high jump, sand bed or cushion bed is provided at the place of landing. You all have seen when the in a high or long jump, an athlete when jumped over the big rod, their cushion bed is there at the place when they are landed. This is because when athletes falls on the ground after performing a high or long jump, what will happen? The momentum of the body becomes zero. As soon as the athlete touches the ground, the momentum of the body of an athlete becomes zero. Means athlete become stop. Athlete is stopped, so the momentum is zero. So if the momentum of an athlete will reduce to zero instantly, means within a second if it will reduce to zero, then it will result in the large force applied on the player. Means if the athlete, when the athlete jump over a high or a long jump, as soon as he reached the ground, the momentum, the motion which his body acquired when he was running before the high or long jump, and as soon as he reaches the floor of the sand or cushion bed, the momentum of the athlete becomes zero within a second. So if the cushion bed will not be there, if a hard surface will be there, then the athlete will get a severe push on his body and he may get hurt. So whereas by providing a cushion bed, the momentum of the player reduced to zero in a delay period means the time will increase. As soon as the cushion, bed or a sand there, when they push inside, so the time will increase. Which time will increase? The momentum becomes zero, time will increase, and due to which less force is applied on the athlete body. So this question can be like that, why there is a shockers are placed on the vehicles or on your cycles, below the seats, in cars, in bus. Again, shocker reduce the shocks from the road to the passenger who are sitting in the bus or in the car. So the time of shock will increase, so the less force will applied on the passenger body. Now the next question. In the next, there is a worksheet. So this worksheet, some questions are solved, some are unsolved. State Newton's second law of motion and prove that Newton's first law of motion is a special case of Newton's second law of motion. You have to state Newton's second law of motion, that force is directly proportional to. I am just giving you a hint how you will write the answers. Try to write the answers that according to Newton's second law, the force is directly proportional to change in momentum per unit time. And according to first law, that if an object is at rest, remain at rest, and if the object is in motion, will continue in motion. In that case, unless and until an unbalanced external force is not applied. So according to Newton's first law, when you put F is equals to zero, what you will get in the second equation? Put in the second equation F zero, then what will be the conclusion you will get? That would be the relation between the first law and the second law. What is meant by momentum? Momentum is the quantity of the motion. Quantity of motion of an object. It can be measured, how it can be measured, and its SI unit. How we can calculate the momentum? Momentum is equals to M cross V and its SI unit. SI unit is mass is kg and velocity is meter per second. So the unit become kg meter per second. Explain how does Newton's first law give the qualitative definition of force? Qualitative definition, you have to write the definition of Newton's first law and how it is related with the force. As we discussed in question one, two objects in the question four, two objects A and B having mass 100 kg and 75 kg moving with velocity 40 km per hour and the B is moving 6 km per hour. Answer the following. Which will have greater inertia? That we discussed already. Inertia has been discussed in Newton's first law, that inertia depend upon mass. Now you can able to calculate which is having a more inertia. Which will having a greater momentum? The formula of momentum is M into V. Now you have to calculate mass into velocity. But you have to convert the unit of kilometer per hour into meter per second. And then you will calculate the momentum. Which will stop first? If equal negative acceleration is applied on both, then you have to calculate force. Which will stop first? If equal negative acceleration, if you are applied retardation, negative acceleration means retardation is applied on both, which will stop first? Now you have to find out. Which will travel greater distance? You have to calculate S, the distance formula. In the distance formula, this is second. S is equals to ut plus half a t square, or with the third, v square minus u square is equals to 2as, or distance is equals to speed upon, what is speed is equals to distance upon time. That is also calculated. You have to find out which formula you will apply it. Which will impart greater impulse? Impulse is a force which is applied for a shorter moment of time, is called impulse. Impulse is a kind of force. So impulse, in place of impulse, you can just think over it. What is the, which will impart greater force? Next, define momentum in SI unit. That is again a one word question. Answer, what is momentum and its SI unit? Now, some questions already I have read the reasoning. Why it is advised to tie the luggage within a rope on the roof bus? So just read the question and which phenomenon you will apply it. This is not the second law of force is inversely proportional to time. It will not. Why it is advised to tie the luggage with the rope on the roof buses? This is the question of inertia. And if the bus is moving, this is the phenomenon of inertia of motion. So with question, how you will find out which phenomena we are going to use it in the reasoning? So when a moving bus suddenly stops, the luggage on its roof still tends to continue in the state of motion due to inertia of motion. That these type of question we discussed many times. As the luggage are on the top of the roof of the buses and the bus is moving, this implies that luggage, the motion is also in the luggage. If the bus suddenly stops, the luggage which was in motion tends to remain in motion. Okay, opposes the state of motion. When it opposes the state of motion, thus to what will happen? It will fall down as soon as the bus suddenly stops. So for that, to avoid the falling of the luggage, it is tied with the rope on the roof of a bus. So this is the phenomena of inertia of motion. Next is, a book slides down a tabletop and comes to rest position after a certain distance. Name the force acting on the book. What type of force are acting on the book? Balanced or unbalanced? Which force brought the book to rest? When the book slides down on the tabletop, two forces are acting. Anything which is at rest on the table or on the floor, always two forces are acting if the object is at rest. That is called balance forces. That is friction force and gravitational force. Or the reaction force, that is called upward direction, right? Gravity, you can say the reaction force or the gravitational force and the friction force between the two surfaces. What name the force acting on the book? That is when the book is resting on the table, two types of forces are acting. When the books are resting, when the books are at the same place, it is stopped on the table, two forces are there, that is friction force and a reaction force against the gravity in the upward direction. When the books are suddenly slipped from the table, gravitational force in the downward direction. What will happen when the gravitational force acting on the downward direction? The book slides down from the table. The two forces are not equal and thus is called unbalanced force. If the books are suddenly slide down from the table, that means gravitational force is more than frictional force. So that if one force is more than another force, then it's called unbalanced. So in this case, when the books are suddenly slides down from the table, gravitational force is more than frictional force and it has become unbalanced. Now, which force brought the book to rest? Again, when the book slides down from the table and it reaches on the floor, it again become rest. So that is the frictional force is responsible for bringing the book to rest. Again, when the book is at rest, frictional force and the gravitation, which is pulling the book downward, and the reaction force, which is acting on the upward direction. That is balanced and the book is again its own position. So these are the type of reasoning of Newton's first law and second law combined. Just write down all the reasoning questions properly in the same order and try to understand the phenomenon which are going to apply in another questions. Okay, then thank you everyone. Learn the PDF properly and write down the notes in a proper order. Thank you and have a nice day.